The year 1987 was the year Philips introduced the world to the CD, the compact disc format. And while Patrick Swayze was Dirty Dancing, Public Enemy was releasing their first album. Yo Bum Rush the Show, Eric B. and Rakim were Paid in Full, while KRS-One and BDP were Criminal Minded. And at the same time, LL Cool J was releasing his second album, Bad. Mike Tyson was the baddest man on the planet, winning the WBA heavyweight boxing title from the hands of James Bonecrusher Smith. 1987 was the year Robert De Niro was untouchable.
I want him dead. I want his family dead. I want his house burnt to the ground.
We saw DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince rock the house, all while Heavy D was living large. During a year that brought us movie classics like Fatal Attraction, Beverly Hills Cop 2, and The Running Man,
Killian, I'll be back.
Ice-T proved to the world that rhyme pays. And while Too Short proved he was born to Mac, Just Ice was busy showing the world he was cool and deadly. All in the same year, we saw Marvelous Marvin Hagler losing his middleweight crown in a shock defeat to Sugar Ray Leonard. We saw the Fat Boys prove to be heavyweights in the world of hip-hop with the release of their album, Crushing. All while the world got their first glimpse of N.W.A. and Posse.
The one-stop hip-hop show, talking everything old-school hip-hop.
Like, comment, and subscribe, you suckers!